Hello, everyone. My name is Victor, and this is Bancha here. We're the co-founders of MangaMagazine.net. So just one point of clarification before we get started. For those of you not familiar with the word manga, comics, manga, for all intentional purposes, just assume they're the same thing. If you want to have a philosophical debate about it, we can have a beer about it later. So to get things started, a very quick industry overview. The comics and manga industry is a huge business. Just the print business alone in the United States and Japan is a $6.5 billion market right now. And on top of that, there are over 100 million monthly visits to some of the top manga and comic sites on the web right now. But as huge fans ourselves of comics and manga, we've been really annoyed by the inability for the traditional publishers, whether it be comics and manga or the publishing industry in general, to be able to tap into this digital market potential. And on top of that, generate innovative content consistently. And why is this? This is because the traditional publishing industry is used to its infrastructure, its processes, the editors, the distributors, the retailers, all those processes to push out the millions of copies of Harry Potter or a particular series that they think most people will like, but not everybody. And that's something that we think that with the digital publishing realm coming up, it's something that we can change. And on top of this, it gives very little opportunities for the large amount of talent that exists out there. So what is MangaMagazine.net? We're a crowdsourcing content platform that's trying to change the publishing industry by trying to unlock this digital market potential by giving our artists the opportunity to monetize their content and to get a large user base to be able to look at their content. We help identify this great talent by offering curated content to our users, and at the same time, the users are actually giving us the feedback as a crowdsourcing site. So just to give you a little idea, here are some images actually just randomly pulled off of our site. There's a huge talent pool. There's a lot of people who are really passionate about this area, and for that matter, it's the same thing for any other genre, any type of genres in the publishing industry. People are very passionate. They're very talented. These are across all three tier levels of our members, and these range from professional artists that have been working for many years in the industry to college students who are still just doodling and just want to show off their talents. So what we tell all our users is, let us help you. Our motto is read, create, share, and we'll help you make money. So let's jump into the demo real quickly. So this is actually our front page of our site. As I mentioned a little bit earlier, we have three tier levels, and this is how we help our users curate our content. So at the member level, any one of you can upload content. For that matter, if you feel like it, upload some tonight. You can upload stick figures, whatever you want. But the idea is that at the member level, everybody can upload content, and then based on our back-end analytics, we look at what's gaining traction, who's coming in and viewing what content. If you read a content, what's the chances of you staying on and reading more pages? Or do you read it and then 99.9% of the people read the first page and leave? We think this is really important because it helps us figure out which are the ones that are generating a lot of interest and getting a lot of traction. And from there, as they move up the tiers, what we do is we provide them ebook publishing support, merchandise support, monetary support. The idea is we help these authors take their content and monetize it, and be able to get users interested in their content and reach out to as many channels as they can. So let's load up a particular author. So Bancha right now is actually loading one of our premium artists, Drake. So he publishes content on our site regularly, and this is his profile page right now. We have two content types that we give our artists the ability to upload. One is illustrations, one is the comics themselves. So the illustration side, what it is it's for artists to upload whatever they want when they draw it. If they want to draw some doodle, if they have some fans, ask for something, or if they have some concept art that they're working on. The idea is that they can upload it here and just show off their portfolio. And then more importantly is the comics themselves. The idea is that we try to make it easy for artists to be able to upload their content onto our site so that it's easily accessible by our users. So in this case, Drake here actually has Sin. This is a series that he uploads on a regular basis. So the idea is once he uploads the content, it's easily available to our users, and if you go in and read it, or select a random chapter that you want to read, so Bancha here is loading up chapter 22. It's an easy to access reader. The idea is that our users can easily come in and quickly start reading the content. And for the author side, once they upload the content, it's just upload and forget. The idea is that any standardized content, we try to simplify it for them. Copyright pages, ads, cover pages. If these are things that you keep uploading over and over again, we try to simplify it for them so they don't have to upload it again. And on top of that, on our side, this reader allows us the ability to insert promotions, ads, and for example, when you click on the very last page of this chapter, what we do right now to encourage our users to share is at the end of every single chapter is a page that encourages our users to share that content they just read. So tell your friends about this particular series, Sin, that you really liked, and you post it on your Facebook, your Twitter, and so on. So let's go back to Drake's profile. The area that we really find that's very important and that we focused on our site about is the social interaction around this. So we have two features that we built in, comments and favorites. So the comment side, most of you are probably very familiar with. The idea is that throughout the site, we embed the ability for our users to be able to comment, interact with our authors. If you interact with the author and they listen to you or they get some ideas from you, you feel like you're more involved. For that matter, we've even had artists actually take it to the next level. They've actually had polls, they've had discussions about what should the next page be, what should the next chapter be. It helps them get rid of that writer's block that some people might run into sometimes. And then the other important part is favorites. So this is very similar to Facebook Like, for those of you who use it. The idea is that next to every artist, every series, every drawing, there's a button, excuse me, that you can click, and essentially you indicate you're a fan of it. So any time that Drake from now on updates his series, posts an image, you're automatically notified of the content being uploaded. The idea is that if you like a particular series of Drake, similar to if you like Oprah, chances are you'll like the other stuff that he posts or the other stuff that he follows. And so hopefully, as our users start following their favorite artists, they start building this portfolio of what they like. And the people who generate these interests, they can share it with all their friends. They can pass them along and say, look, I like Drake and he likes this particular series. And since you share my interests, you likely will like this as well. So what have been our results? So we launched our beta in Q3 of last year, and then this site that you just saw was launched in January, and we've been very happy with what we've seen. Our hypothesis behind this was always that we've got very passionate users. It's similar to just look at the lines of the movie theater when The Hunger Games came out. Same idea. They're very passionate. They like to spend a lot of time on our site, and our data has shown that. We see about each visit on our site, about 9 minutes on our site right now, and each user viewing about 26 pages. What this means is that in the last 3 months, we've grown to about 6 million page views per month right now, with about 230,000 visits and 90,000 unique visitors coming per month. Just in the last month alone, we've seen 64% visit growth and 49% unique visitor growth just in the last month. But the key part that we're the most proud of is the fact that we didn't just get lucky and sign Spider-Man, you know, and then suddenly everybody the floodgates opened and everybody came in. We have a community of over 400 manga right now, and this is supported by an artist community of over 650 artists right now. And on top of that, there's the 20,000 registered users that follow and actively interact with these artists, support them, provide the community, and that doesn't even include all the people who don't register. So where do we go from here? Our users have given us very strong and opinionated feedback on two areas, international and mobile. So up until now, since January, we've been focusing on the US market. I mean, especially since we're English speaking, the main focus has been on US, Canada, London, and so on. But our users are very international. It's a very strong fan base, and they've told us they want to help us translate. So in April, we're launching out a new feature that allows users to help collaborate and translate all their content. German, French, Chinese, whatever our user community is able to help out with, they'll send the translated content to our artists, and the artists can then put it into their content. And then mobile. I mean, just looking around, I see a bunch of iPads everywhere. The idea is that users really like to be able to read their content wherever, and they've told us, on their couch, they want to be able to load up the site and read our content. So we're targeting launching an app, iPad app, in May. So with that, I'll open the floor for questions. Go ahead.
Do you have a ratings-based restriction system?
So the question is, do we have a ratings-based restriction system? And to make sure I got the question, you mean something like a maturity filter or something like that? Great question. We've had a lot of users tell us that we should do this, and we've been looking into it, and it's at the top of our list. I keep bugging Boncho about it, but it's something that we definitely know it's important, and it's at the top of our list that we're working on right now. Great question. The question is, do we have any measures in place to protect copyrights, trademarks, and so on? So I split it into two parts just to make sure I answer it right. There's our portion of the copyright, so if we have an artist come onto our site and we work with them, how do we protect our rights, and how do they protect their rights? So with our top premium artists, we sign exclusive distributing licenses with all our premium artists. The idea is that we help them grow, and they share a bit of the profits with us, and that's how we share it, and we want to share a very mutual relationship to help them grow. And so that's the portion that we've been focusing on in terms of if we want to protect their content, they'll naturally also in turn, we'll be protecting their copyright as well.
Okay. So so the question is, do we charge anything upfront for the reader to read?
Right? Well, for the artist.
For the artist?
Charge for the artist.
Okay. So we do not charge anything upfront for the artist. And the reason for that is that we want to promote the artist to feel that this is a platform for them to share their work and subsequently monetize based on the content that they upload on our website. It's not that you have to pay in order to upload. It's you get the work on our website, you get it viral based on what we have provided you in terms of the different tools that we provide, and then you monetize based on that.
Okay. I'll use that as a segue to answer the question, how do we make money with this site?
Right.
So we're still a new site, and we're working really hard to figure this out. But from our perspective, we have a lot of content flooding in. We have a lot of great talent. And our perspective is, once we sign these licensing rights with our top artists, we have the content as the core focus. And from there, we're looking into a subscription system. So our readers would then pay something like Hulu and Hulu Plus. You can read the content free, but it'll be a little bit slower. And if you pay 99 cents a month, you'll get access to your favorite content. And then from there, we can expand into book publishing, e-books. We've already done quite a few experiments in terms of uploading some of our content onto Amazon. So the idea is expand out and make it so that anybody who uploads content on our site can automatically get posted onto Amazon or Barnes & Nobles and so on. So we're hoping to branch out as many ways as we can to make money off of the content we get. That's a great question, actually. So the question is, how do we deal with artists who may already be professional and have existing contracts with existing publishing houses? So we make it very clear when we talk to all our artists that we want to sign exclusive distribution licenses on the particular content on our site. We're not trying to, there's this stigma that goes on in the industry right now where you sign over your soul, essentially, when you sign on to some of the big publishing houses. We're trying to avoid that. Everybody doesn't like that, and that's why they're actually interested in us. So what we tell them is, we're signing on for the particular content you have. It's your, we can't look at your agreement with the other publishing house, but as long as your other publishing house doesn't own everything that you ever do, which is hopefully rare, and from all the people we've talked to, is not the common case, they can actually sign the agreement with us to be able to license their particular content. And that's the key aspect that a lot of them really like, is that they can keep their content rights. We're just licensing it and helping them monetize it, and then we take a little bit of a cut of the earnings that they make.
Okay, so the question is, if you have a script, can we match you with another artist on the site? And that's a very good question, and we have already seen that there are writers on our website coming in to post stories, just so many of them. And the answer is, we are planning to build a feature for that, because that's really just a common collaboration tool. And as Victor mentioned, one of the collaboration we're building is translation. But just to take another step is to match two people together. And yes, we're planning to do that. But currently, right now, we do not have that.
So, Victor, I have a question for you.
Yeah.
Are you afraid that large publishers might view your platform as a great way to find great writers, great artists, and then pluck them away from your platform?
It's a great question. So the question is, I guess everybody heard it, so I won't repeat it. Are we worried of other publishers poaching our artists? So I mentioned before that we sign exclusive distribution licenses with our content artists, and we think it's actually a great thing. The traditional publishing houses can't rely on us as their future source of all content. The way their current business model is set up is that they have to be able to support very large volumes coming from particular artists. And we see that with our current setup, we can encourage a lot more people to come in, and we can encourage a larger community to be built up from it. So, I mean, is it a risk? It always will be, I think. But we actually think that between these licenses and the community feeling we're building, and most importantly, the fact we're letting them keep their content rights, that they'll be happy to stay with us.
So one more question. Right now, it's obviously very much fantasy focused, right? Have you guys explored taking your platform and leveraging for sci-fi or romance or whatever else?
I guess the question is, have we considered expanding the genres of the on possible media on the site? And the answer is yes, actually. If you go to on our website right now, we have designed the website in such a way that will they'll help the experience not only for reading manga or comics, but also for reading blogs, for viewing illustrations as well. So this, we see that we can expand into different areas. It can be fantasy book, as you mentioned. or it can be anything, any type of reading experience you can upload to our website, and we'll try to promote it to make it viral for you, and hence make it, and you can, and the writers and the script writers, artists can monetize from our platform.
That's a great question, and the question is, beyond just trying to protect our content from a contract side, are we thinking of any tools to help artists, proprietary tools that can help them grow their content and provide a better experience? And the question is, yes, we've definitely been thinking about it. So one of the tools we had already mentioned was translation collaboration, but there's a lot of opportunities here that a lot of our artists are giving us feedback. One of the key problems that we've heard, and actually we were just talking to somebody in the audience just a moment ago about, was the inability to read comics on your smartphone right now because of the fact that the screen is so small. So we're definitely looking into that. I mean, off the top of my head right now, we're not working. And if you have any ideas, please definitely come talk to us afterwards. Yeah. Treat you to a beer. That's a really good idea, and I think we definitely should look into that.
Yeah. And just to add to that, we think mixed media is very interesting. And if you go out to our website right now, not only that we are offering just images or graphics, but it's a mix of graphics, text, and videos, and you know, of course, music as well. So you can check it out.
Yeah, actually, going off of music, that was my question, was do you guys plan on maybe putting together an anthology of all of the different manga comics crowdfunded by the user base, and then possibly having them submit soundtracks for the anthology and sending it out in the mail as like a, you know, 100 manga comics along with a soundtrack, possibly a DVD, and getting it paid for upfront, keeping a percentage of the profit like Hit Record does?
That's a really great question. Have we thought of ways to build an anthology? The question is, have we thought of ways to build an anthology, include music into it, and sell it as sort of a product for people to see an anthology of what's available on our site? And I think that hits at the heart of what we struggle with and are very happy to have the problem of, which is there's so many different ways we can monetize on the content we have. I mean, just between the two of us, we have constant arguments of, should we go this way? Should we go that way? There's just so many ways to make money, and that's a great idea. It also sort of echoes one of the sentiments that a lot of our artists are talking about, which is using Kickstarter, and that's something that we're definitely looking into. Honestly, haven't looked into doing that particular idea, but great idea, and we'll definitely take it back to our artists.
Yeah. And a very interesting project that's going on right now is that there is actually a voice over community group, so they're actually very interested in our comic, and they want to actually voice act it. You know, that's also one way to do it as well. And that is actually organic. We didn't contact them at first. So basically that group just got created by, you know, very interested, you know, followers and fans. And you know, it's great.
Yeah. So can you maybe comment on scanlation sites and their popularity and how that ties in with what you guys are doing or trying to disrupt?
So the question is, can we comment on scanlation sites? What do we think about scanlation? For those who are not familiar with scanlation, essentially it's a site that they take the latest, the most recent published content, let's say of Harry Potter, or in this case a lot of the comics, they release it same day, translate it into local language, and essentially it's a piracy site. We think that the main issue with why scanlation sites are doing so well is because of the issue that all the consumers can't get access to the content quickly. In the particular case of scanlation, a lot of the times it's Japanese content coming out on one day, and it would take weeks, months, even years to get out into translated form into the United States. So we think that with our platform being able to quickly and immediately distribute the content, it will resolve a lot of this issue. And on top of that, I mean, from our perspective, we want to help our artists make money across all different sorts of avenues, and it's not just sell your particular chapter. So that's why we're looking into subscription, so that you just pay and then you can read everything on our site. So you don't feel like you have to pay for a particular content and feel obligated to feel like you're getting ripped off or something like that.
Okay. The question is, are we considering using instant translator or other more sophisticated mechanisms for the site? And we're actually not going to use instant translator, and the reason is because it possibly will affect the quality of the translation. And as a site, I mean, we want to position ourselves as a premium site where people come and enjoy the manga and comics, and we want to provide the best experience possible. And as a result, we are actually going to rely on the community who are already very passionate about the work They will come and translate for us.
For free or?
For free, actually. They have already expressed interest in doing so.
The question is, how do we plan on divvying up the revenues that we take in from our subscription model? So right now, we're still juggling it, and we're still debating about it, but the model that we're talking about right now is 99 cents per month. You come in, and you indicate the author that you like. So the idea is you pay 99 cents a month to be able to read the artist you like at a faster rate than the existing pace, so the Hulu Plus style. And then at $2.99, it would be an all-you-can-eat. So you can read anything on the site at its fastest pace for $2.99. And from there, we would divvy up. So if it's the 99 cent, the author gets direct credit, and we can just split the proceeds from there. Versus if it's the $2.99 or whatever the price may be, we would just do it as a pool where, based on traffic and using our backend analytics, we can see how much we should divvy up to each of the artists.
Sure.
That's a great question. So the question is, 5 years from now, if things go well, what would we like to be able to see happen? Did I get that correctly? So we see Manga Magazine as a platform. The platform is to leverage a very passionate user base focused on a particular genre of publishing. And our idea is that once we've built this particular platform, we can expand it into all different types of arenas. So imagine doing the same thing for genre fiction like The Hunger Games, or doing it for photography, or for any type of specialized area where we think we can find a very passionate user base that also has an opportunity for us to go in and disrupt the opportunity to generate great content. That's where we're planning on going into. So in our perspective, we would have multiple sites all under the umbrella company, but these will all be sites serving up different types of genre which have strong user bases. And from there, we would monetize each particular segment and leveraging the code that we build on our existing platform.
All right, we're out of time. How can the Philly Tech community help you guys out?
So two things. We're looking for advisors. So we've just got the two of us. Any opinions, any advice, and people who've been in the digital publishing realm, we definitely should talk afterwards. We always would like advice as well as experienced advisors, so that's one thing. And then, of course, we're beginning our fundraising efforts, so we're looking to fundraise so that we can take this to the next level, be able to launch off to next additional platforms, to be able to build out those additional proprietary tools, as well as features that our users are asking for.
Awesome. Good, you guys are on board.